Dear colleagues, this is a case of closed angle glaucoma, cataract with nucleus sclerosis of 2+. Notice the fact that the pupil is not very well dilated, and I'm going to use in this case the Mishev chopper to finish the case in a safe manner. The capsulorhexis is done aiming for a fairly larger than the pupil capsulorhexis, so it's done a little bit underneath the iris margin, the pupillary margin. Hydrodissection, and I will not try to rotate too much the nucleus in this glaucoma patients. Anterior segment is pretty fragile, so I don't want to damage the zonules in any way. So starting to aspirate the cortex in the middle of the pupil, and then do a stop and chop technique. And with this Mishev chopper that have the tip of the chopper spatulated one, is very very easy to crack and separate the segments. I do another trench here, like a Y shape letter, so I'm able to take out a small fragment of that half of the nucleus out in order to make some room inside the bag. And in this way it's very easy now to rotate the nucleus and have the two parts of the nucleus very well separated up to the posterior plate also. Another small trench here, and have the second heminucleus divided into two quadrants, and from this point on the surgery becomes very easy. Notice the fact that always you gotta stay in the middle of the pupil with the phacoemulsification, and you really don't need to hurry in this case, since you barely have space in the anterior chamber to move the instruments. So the entire phacoemulsification need to be inside the bag. Therefore, bevel, it's here, it's sideways, and the foot pedal, it's very very carefully pressed for short bursts of emulsification. So you gotta really pay attention to the foot pedal in these cases, and not have it pressed for long periods of time. Just accelerate it and release, accelerate and release. It's just small bits and pieces you take out, and gradually, slowly but surely, you finish the phacoemulsification. You really really need to stay patient in these cases and not hurry at any point of time, since you have a small arterial chamber and a very fluctuated posterior capsule. In these cases, glaucoma patients always have problems of posterior capsule laxity, and it's very very easy to aspirate one if you keep the foot pedal pressed longer than you should. So really small acceleration and release the foot pedal, and you finish the case pretty steady. Aspirating the cortex, especially in this glaucoma patients, you really need to make sure the entire cortex in the bag is aspirated. At the end of the clean up, you may choose to check with the Sinsky hook or with the Mishev chopper, and make sure the bag is clean at the end of the cortical removal, since every viscoelastic or cortical remnants left into the bag or into the anterior chamber will start an inflammatory process post-op, which you really don't need to have in these glaucoma patients. Injecting the IOL under irrigation straight into the bag is very easy, and at the end, cleaning up the anterior chamber from any viscoelastic and push back the iris root. Thank you for your time.